गुड मॉर्निंग। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द वंस वी डिड द जनरल कैरेक्टराइजेशन ऑफ एम्पलीफायर्स। इन द जनरल कैरेक्टराइजेशन वी रोट द थेवेनिन्स इक्विवेलेंट सर्क्यूट टू रिप्लेस द एम्पलीफायर इंटरनली एंड वी ट्राई टू एनालाइज एंड फाइंड द वैल्यूज ऑफ इनपुट रेजिस्टेंस आर इन three types of voltage gain, AVO, out, open circuit voltage gain, then AV dash, which is voltage gain with load, and last is GV, the overall voltage gain. So we found three types of voltage gain like this, and we also gave the relation that overall voltage gain will be the least of the lot. Open circuit voltage gain would have the highest value. The voltage gain with load will have the next higher value, and overall voltage gain will have the least value in a circuit. And later on, we came to find the output resistance, which follows a fixed procedure to remove RL and connect a voltage source VX, sending a current IX into the output side of the circuit, and short the input signal source. So when we short the input signal source, whatever would be the ratio of the voltage source which we connect on the output side to the current Vx by Ix, that would give us a measure of the impedance or resistance seen on the output side of the amplifier. So we call that our R out, and we try to find that value. Now we started off with our analysis of various MOSFET amplifiers. I told you the first and most commonly used MOSFET amplifier is the common source amplifier, where we have both voltage and current gain more than one. Here we rarely find the current gain, but in the end I'll show you how it could be done. So especially in MOSFETs, current gain is not important. Can you tell me why? In BJTs, current gain has some meaning, but in MOSFETs, what do we mean by current gain? Yes? What is the meaning of current gain? What is the meaning of voltage gain? Please speak up.
Output will be more than the input.
It's a ratio of output to input, right? A gain in general is a ratio of output quantity to the input quantity. If I say it is voltage gain, it is output voltage by input voltage. And whenever we talk about gain, usually it will be more than one. Output is more than input. You're right. And you always have to define it in terms of ratio of output to input. So when I say current gain, it will be output current by input current. What happens in an FET? What would be the value of input current? What is the input current in an FET? What is the value of this current? Yes? How many times to tell you? Yeah. Input current would be zero in an FET. So there is no point in finding the ratio of output current to input current. Current gain is a ratio of output current. In this case, maybe if I call the output current as the drain current, ID is equal to I naught. So it is the ratio of output current to input current. In this case, it is the ratio of ID to IG. We know IG will always be zero. So this turns out to be infinite, and there is no meaning in finding out this quantity. Is that clear? That's why in MOSFET, we restrict our analysis to find only three important parameters: the input impedance Rin, the output impedance Rout, and the voltage gain. Okay, please remember that. So we have written a simple MOSFET circuit here in the left side, and we have connected a signal source Vsig having an internal resistance Rsig to this circuit. And we have shown that the voltage across the gate and source region is Vi, which can also be same as VGS, the gate source voltage. And on the output side, we have a single drain resistance RD across which we are going to measure the output voltage V naught. So in this circuit, we first job is we check whether this is AC equivalent. Here you see I have only AC signal generator. There are no DC sources here. So only AC voltage is there. No capacitors. So already what I have is the simplified or AC equivalent circuit. So whatever we have here, it is the AC equivalent circuit itself. Directly we have written that. I also showed you how we can get the AC equivalent circuit if a complete MOSFET amplifier with biasing resistor, capacitors, coupling capacitors, DC source, if all are given, how to get the AC equivalent circuit, I have done yesterday. Anyway, here we have directly written the AC equivalent circuit because we have only the AC voltage source and no capacitors and no DC voltages in this circuit. So once you have the AC equivalent circuit, the next thing what we should do is replace this MOSFET. The active device should be replaced with its equivalent model. We have written the small signal equivalent model of MOSFET in our previous module. Module 1, we had written the small signal equivalent circuit of MOSFET. So we are just replacing the MOSFET with its small signal model, as you can see here. And then we are bringing the other elements from this circuit. Okay. So VSIG and RSIG are connected between gate and source in this main circuit. And the same thing we are doing here. We will try to find the input impedance Rin after the voltage source looking into the amplifier like this. And on the output side between drain and source, I have the drain resistance RD connected. And output voltage is measured across RD. Now, source is grounded because it is common source amplifier. Now we'll begin our analysis and we try to find the first parameter, that is the input impedance. How do I find the input impedance? We can clearly see that the input impedance can be defined as the input voltage which is appearing here divided by the input current. In this case, the input voltage has some value, but the current is zero. So naturally, it is infinity. The impedance or the resistance becomes infinity. And even without taking voltage to current ratio, I can directly tell that the resistance is infinity in this circuit by looking at the open circuit connection here. The input side is open circuited. So if you are looking into an open circuit, it automatically means that the resistance is infinity, right? Only when you have an infinite resistance, it will be an open circuit. The next parameter which we wanted to find out is the voltage gain. First, we'll find the open circuit voltage gain. In this case, since there is no additional load resistance RL, we have not included any load resistance RL. So the voltage gain with load and open circuit voltage gain will be the same. AVO and AV dash will be the same. So how do we find this AVO? Open circuit voltage gain can be found by finding the ratio of output voltage to the input voltage. So I should find V naught by VI ratio. Remember, VI is equal to VGS in this circuit. The gate source voltage is same as VI here. In the next circuit which we see, it will be different. Here, the gate source voltage and the input voltage are the same. So I can write V naught by VI as V naught by VGS. And let me try to find the value of V naught in this output part of the circuit. In order to find the value of V naught, we consider the parallel combination of R naught and RD as one single resistance. R naught parallel RD, through which the current coming from this current source GM VGS is flowing. And depending on the direction of current flow, you can see it creates a voltage across this resistor in a direction opposite to which we are measuring V naught. So since the current flows from bottom to top, the voltage generated will be positive at the bottom and negative at the top. But V naught we are measuring always with positive connected to the drain. Okay, if you have a CRO probe, you will connect the positive of the probe to drain and the negative to the source. Hence, we always have to use a negative sign because the actual voltage which is developed is in the opposite direction to what we are measuring. So minus GM VGS, which is the value of the current into the resistance. Current into resistance gives you a voltage, IV, Ohm's law. So we are just substituting that. And since we have divide by VGS, you see VGS cancels. Output voltage is minus GM VGS into R0 parallel RD. And okay, this is the value of output voltage and the voltage gain here will be minus GM into R0 parallel RD because we are going to cancel out VGS. Okay. And I also told you here, there is no load resistance included in this circuit. Since there is no load resistance, the voltage gain with load AV dash will be same as voltage gain without load AVO. And both will be equal to minus GM R0 parallel RD. Now, the last thing which we should find in this circuit is our output resistance or output impedance R out. How do we find the value of output impedance R out? Remember, what should I do in the circuit? I have to make what? The signal generator voltage zero. V sig should be made zero on the input side, right? Do I have a resistance here? What do I have here? The equivalent circuit, this is the source, this is the gate. The signal generator is connected here. And on the output side, I have what? The current source, dependent current source, GM VGS. You have the output resistance R0. This is part of the model. The MOSFET model has these two elements only. And the external resistance RD. And if at all you had any RL, see, I've just rewritten the same circuit. It's the same circuit which I've written again. I've only made the input signal generator VSIG zero. The output side is retained as it is. And since there is no additional load resistance, here what I'll do, I'll directly connect an external voltage source VX, sending a current IX into the circuit. And whatever resistance I measure here, that is called R out. So R out is defined as VX by IX when VSIG is equal to zero. Please understand the procedure. I told you, you should remember the procedure to find the output resistance R out. So run the output part of the circuit with a voltage source VX, sending a current IX into the circuit. And you just have to make the input signal generator zero. The input voltage should be made zero whenever we are calculating output resistance because we are connecting a voltage source on the output side. Okay. So once we have this, we just have to find VX by IX. So here, when VSIG is zero, can you tell me what happens to VGS in this circuit? This VGS or VI, will I have any value? See, I have an open loop on the input side. So this becomes zero. Since the input side of the circuit is open, VGS becomes zero. Okay. And there is no signal generator also. the current flowing, we know the input current is always zero. It's open circuited. So this voltage will also be zero. So what happens to this current on the output side? What will happen to the value of GM VGS? VGS is zero means zero. The value of this current becomes zero. How will I represent a current source which is zero? If there is no current flowing, we always represent it with a open circuit. Yes or no? Whenever there is no current flowing, you just have to open, remove this. This is not there. Just open this current source. You have an open circuit. Now, if I try to find the impedance, try to find the Thevenin's equivalent impedance looking between these two terminals. You are looking to the left. What do you get? You can directly say R out is capital R D in parallel with R naught. I just have two resistors in parallel for this voltage which we are connecting on the output side and the current which is flowing Ix. It gets divided only into two branches, one through this R naught, one through R D. So the effective output resistance of this circuit will be R naught in parallel with R D. Is this clear? If you have any doubts, please ask. Therefore, output resistance R out is equal to.
Ma'am, can you repeat the last part, ma'am?
Yeah.
After the open circuit.
Yes. After this open circuit, now say I'll call these terminals as AA dash. I have to find the resistance looking between A and A dash to the left. Right. So what do you see when you have to the left? You're trying to find this Vx by Ix. You're seeing just the parallel combination of two resistors. There is nothing here. This is also open circuited. The input side does not come into picture at all. Even this is open. So you just see two resistors in parallel, that is Rd in parallel with R0. If I look to the left of A and A dash. So this is AA dash. You are seeing one resistance RD and one resistance R naught. And here you don't have anything else. It's open. So what would be the Thevenin's equivalent resistance or effective resistance here? If you try to find the effective resistance as seen here, this is RD. If you are trying to find the effective resistance here, any voltage which is connected here, any voltage divided by this current will be the value of the resistance here. And that resistance you can see, if we apply Thevenin's theorem, what do? We directly just try to find the resistance, effective resistance between the points A and A dash, which is just the parallel combination of R naught and RD, nothing else. This would be same as Vx by Ix in this circuit. So if you try to find Vx by Ix separately also, you see that it will just be, what would be the value of Ix? Ix would be Vx divided by R0 parallel Rd because it's the parallel combination of these two resistors which exists in this circuit. There's nothing else. So I am interested in finding Vx by Ix, which represents the output impedance or output resistance. It will be the parallel combination of these two resistors. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, that's all. You have to find only three parameters and we are done with the analysis. So you can see this is one of the simplest circuit which we have considered. The common source amplifier. Without any biasing resistor or DC voltage or load resistance, anything. We have replaced the MOSFET with its equivalent small signal model. And we have determined the value of the three important parameters, input impedance, voltage gain, and the output resistance. Okay. So let us try to solve one simple problem based on this. And then I will show you what happens if there is a if it is a practical circuit which has biasing resistors and all that. Okay, I think I had written the problem somewhere here. Yeah. Okay, make a note of this problem. A common source amplifier has a drain current of 0.25 milliamps. So let me list what is given. ID 0.25 milliamps. VOV. What does VOV stand for?
VGS minus VT.
VGS minus VT. The overdrive voltage. It is 0.25 volts. VA represents the voltage. We call that as what? The channel length modulation voltage. So whenever we have channel length modulation to be considered, this helps us, VA helps us in measuring R naught. Okay. So VA is needed to help find R naught, which is part of our model. R sig is given 100 kilo ohm. RL load resistance is there in this circuit, 20 kilo ohm. RD is there, which is also 20 kilo ohm. You are supposed to find Rin, AV naught, R naught, AV and GV. Let me try to draw the circuit. So according to what is given, RD is given. Okay. You'll have VDD here. And RL is also given. So generally we'll have a coupling capacitor connecting RL. Okay. And the output voltage is measured here. Whenever RL is given, it will be connected to the output part of this circuit, to the drain, through a coupling capacitor. Biasing resistance is not given here. On the input side, he has just given us R sig, which is 100K, and V sig is given. Okay. And he already tells us the value of drain current ID is given as 0.25 milliampere. This represents the gate source voltage VGS or VI. Okay. If required, you can have a capacitor here also, coupling capacitor. I told, usually we use one on the input, one on the output. So this is the circuit which he has mentioned for us, and we'll write its equivalent circuit. So first write the AC equivalent circuit of this. In AC equivalent circuit, what should I do? I should short all the capacitors. I should short all the DC voltage sources. So if I have a DC voltage source like this connected between this point and ground, it will be replaced with a short circuit. In effect, this end will be connected to ground. Again, this capacitor also will be shorted. So all capacitors will be shorted. All DC voltage sources will be shorted. Okay, is that clear? Now, what is left in the circuit? You just have the MOSFET with source grounded, and on the output side from the drain terminal, so this is the drain terminal, you have a resistance RD connected between drain and ground. See, this VDD point is grounded, and from the same point, because this capacitor CC2 is shorted, I have another resistance RL connected to ground. So this would be the output part of the circuit. I'll be measuring output voltage across this RL. between drain and source, you will measure the output voltage. Okay, so we have rewritten the circuit after getting the AC equivalent. On the input side, after shorting this capacitance, I directly have to connect the signal generator with its internal resistance, RSIG. So you just have to connect the signal generator and RSIG. And as usual, you have VGS here. Is this clear? So this represents the AC equivalent circuit. So remember, getting AC equivalent circuit is by shorting capacitors, by shorting DC voltage sources. What's the next step? Next step is to replace this MOSFET. In the next step, I should replace the MOSFET with its small signal equivalent model. So let me replace the MOSFET first. According to the MOSFET replacement, between gain and source, I don't have anything. I have an infinite resistance. Whereas between the drain and source, I'll have a dependent voltage source of value GM into VGS in parallel with a resistance R0. So this is the replacement for this MOSFET. Okay. So the MOSFET in the above circuit will be replaced with this. Now our job is to write the other elements in the original circuit to this, add on the elements. On the input side, what do I have? I have RSIG and I have the voltage source VSIG. VSIG in series with RSIG. Whatever is there, just connect it. And the voltage here is VGS, which is equal to VI. Between gate and source, I have a voltage VGS. And on the output side, what do I have between drain and source? I have two resistors, RD in parallel with RL. So you have the parallel combination of two resistors connected on the output side. And you'll be measuring the output voltage here. And what should happen to the source terminal? The source terminal is grounded. So this gives us the small signal equivalent model. This would be the small signal equivalent model for the CS amplifier, which is shown, given in the problem. This is the model. Now, my first job is to find the value of GM and R0. There are two unknown parameters, GM and R0, in the model of the MOSFET. And to find that, I have some DC voltages and currents given. Do you remember the relationship between GM, ID and VOV? We know that. How can I represent GM? You should remember all this. GM, we did in the previous module, can be defined as twice ID by VOV or VGS minus VT. This is one of the relations which we derived when we wrote the equivalent model of the MOSFET. We got the value of the transconductance gain GM as 2ID by VOV. The value of ID is given as 0.25 milliamps and VOV is given as 0.25 volts. So this is 2 into 0.25 milli divided by 0.25 volts. Can you tell me how much will this be? If I cancel 0.25.
Two millimoles
or 2 milliampere per volt. Anything you can take. So this would be the value of GM. Please remember the relation. Usually in problems, they do this. They give you ID. If they don't give ID, they would have given the biasing circuit. You should first do the DC analysis and find ID. from the biasing circuit, and then you should find VGS, and then you should find GM. In this problem, they have directly given us the value of ID and VOV. So directly we are taking. Next is how to find R0. This small signal equivalent resistance R0 is defined as the channel length modulation voltage VA divided by ID. That's what I was telling you. This VA is needed to find R0. So if they don't mention this R0, or if they say VA can be neglected, then R0 can be treated as infinity. Sometimes they'll directly say this VA can be neglected. So no channel length modulation. In that sense, you can remove R0 from the circuit and you can say it is infinity. So if I just remove it, it's an open circuit. But here it is present. 50 volts divided by 0.25 milliamps. How much would this be?
20 kilo ohms. 20 kilo ohms.
Okay. So R0 is also 20K. I think they have given RD and RL also as 20K. Okay. So now I have all the values in this circuit. All we have to do, now I can do the small signal analysis. Okay. How do we apply the small signal analysis? Therefore, first thing I should find the input resistance. Now, small signal analysis. Where do I find the input resistance? The input resistance is always found looking into the circuit to the right on the input side after the signal generator. So if you have the signal generator here, after signal generator, if you see towards the right, whatever resistance you see, that is the input impedance. And as I told you, since the current is zero and since there is an open circuit here, this input resistance in this circuit is infinity. Whenever you are looking into an open circuit, you can directly say there is no other resistance, just an open circuit. So Rin will surely be infinity. Okay. It's very easy for us to find Rin in a MOSFET circuit. In BJT, it will not be so easy. Next thing what we should find is the open circuit voltage gain, AVO. AVO is defined as output voltage by input voltage. So first, what is the value of output voltage in this circuit? How do I find the output voltage? You can directly see we have done the analysis. You have a current GM into VGS, which is passing through parallel combination of three resistors. Now, instead of two, I have R0 parallel, RD parallel, RL. Can I write the parallel combination of all these three together? R0, RD, RL. Across which I am going to measure the output voltage like this, whereas this current is flowing in the opposite direction. So what would be the value of the voltage drop across this resistor? The value of current is GM VGS. The value of the current with a negative sign, because the actual drop will be developed in this direction, because current always is assumed to flow from high potential to low potential. So because of the direction of the current source, this would be the drop, but we are measuring it in the opposite direction. That's why minus sign. Minus of current into resistance. What's the value of resistance? R0 parallel, RD parallel, RL. I think all the three resistors are 20K. So you can easily calculate. Here VGS and VI are equal, so I can replace VI with VGS. I'll cancel out VGS. Can you tell me what would be the value of AVO? We know GM minus of 2 milli mo into 20K in parallel with 20K in parallel with 20K. So what would this value be? 1/3 of 20K,
13.33.
after multiplying. Yeah, this will be 20k by 3, I think around 6.67k. You need not even calculate here. When you have a parallel combination of three resistors, we know the effective resistance will be divided by 3. This into 2 milli minus 13.33. Yeah? Okay, R naught 50 by 0.25, is it 20k or 200k? Check out once.
200k.
I think this should be 200k, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, usually this R naught is a larger resistance. Please rectify that. This VA by ID, 50 volts by 0.25 milliamps is 200K. So what will happen here then? This will be 200 in parallel with 20 in parallel with 20, which means what will I get? 20 in parallel with 20 will be 10. So you can do 200K in parallel with 10K. These two, if I take the parallel combination of two equal resistors, it will be R by 2. Yes or no? These simple rules you should remember from network analysis. Next, I want you to find what is the parallel combination of 200 in and 10K. So 200 into 10 divided by 200 plus 10. 2000 divided by 210, how much will it be? Check out your answers now. 9.52. Is that right?
After multiplying with 2, we'll get 19.04.
Okay, after multiplying, you'll get 19.04. Okay. Okay, one more thing here. One small mistake is there. Can you tell me what that is? What is AVO supposed to mean?
RL should be not considered.
Exactly. We have considered RL here. I was trying to think what else might be wrong. So one more small thing here is, whenever I find open circuit voltage gain, I should not consider RL. I'll consider RL when I consider AV dash. Please remember, we are trying to find AVO. Anyway, it is okay. Actually, whatever value you have found is AV dash. I think anyway, we need to find that also. But for AVO, remember it is V naught by VI when RL is infinity. I should not consider this RL. So please remove RL from your computation. If RL is infinity in this open circuit, I'll just have R naught parallel RD. Is that clear? So whenever you find the open circuit voltage, that's why it's called AVO, open circuit voltage gain, RL should be made infinity. So when we do this, I think we'll get double the previous value. Yeah. Minus 19 to 36.36. Can you calculate and tell me?
Yes, ma'am. 36.36.
Yeah. So this is the open circuit voltage gain. Next, you can find voltage gain with load. Whatever we have found, we had found just now, that is voltage gain with load. What would that be? Voltage gain with load will be, you can directly say AVO into RL by R0 plus RL, either like that, or from the circuit, if you see, if you observe from this circuit, this is nothing but V0 by VI when RL is not infinity. That means when RL is part of the circuit. So without making RL infinity, if I have to find the voltage gain, then that would be defined either like this, or you can write it as minus GM into the parallel combination of all the three resistors, like what we did just before. We had written just before the same thing. You will get it as minus GM into R0 parallel, RD parallel, RL. All the three resistors in parallel and the current flowing, because here RL should not be removed. Then VGS and VGS in the numerator and denominator get cancelled. You'll have this. So whether you calculate using this relation or using this relation, you should get the same answer. Actually, I think we had got the answer.
19.047.
Yeah. We had
this. How did minus 36.36 came?
200k in parallel with 10k. R0 parallel RD, that's all.
Okay.
Into 2 milli.
Yes, ma'am.
So without RL, what we get, that is AVO, open circuit voltage gain. And with RL, what we got, that is AV dash. Okay. Next, we can find GV. The voltage gain, what? Overall voltage gain. Let's find overall voltage gain. GV, V0 by Vsig. So final output voltage V0 divided by the signal generator voltage Vsig. How do I find out that? What is V0 now? Same as before, GM VGS into R0 parallel RD parallel RL. Yes or no? The output voltage V0 is the current into the parallel combination of all the three resistors. You look at the circuit. So I'll write V0 as minus GM VGS into R0 parallel RD parallel RL. This is the final output voltage which I have in this circuit. Just look at the output side of the circuit. The output voltage is a measure of the current into parallel combination of all the three resistors. Because whenever I'm measuring overall voltage gain, I should find the final output voltage including the load resistor RL. Okay. So whatever we got in AV dash, similar to that. But on the input side, I should see, can I say Vsig is equal to VGS? Will it be the same in this? Can you relate the signal generator voltage to VGS on the input side? See, because I need a ratio of V0 to Vsig and not V0 to VGS. How do you relate this VGS or VI with Vsig? Look at this circuit and tell me.
Vsig is equal to drop across Rsig and VGS.
Will there be a drop across Rsig?
No, ma'am, because current is zero. So Vsig is equal to VGS.
The current is zero. It is open circuited. So drop across this resistor is also zero. There is no drop across this resistor. So what will happen to this voltage? It will be same as Vsig. VGS is same as Vsig. You say Vsig is equal to VGS. Here you can say Vsig is equal to VGS. because Ig is zero and drop across R sig will be zero. Okay. So now, what did you get as the overall voltage gain? It is minus Gm into R naught parallel Rd parallel RL, which is exactly the same as Av dash. So this value is same as Av dash, which we got as minus 19.047. Remember, there is no unit. If you want to write a unit, you should write volt per volt. This numerator and denominator both are volts. V naught by V sig both are in volts. Either volt per volt or don't write anything. Is this clear? So I hope you understood the difference between all the three voltage gains. Don't forget, when we do AVO, you should remove RL. RL shouldn't be included. When you do AV dash, RL should be included. And when you do GV, RSIG and RL both should be included. But here RSIG has no effect in this circuit because I don't have a bias resistor here. I'll show you in a later example. If we have a bias resistor here, then there will be a drop across RSIG because there's going to be a current flowing. Here there is no current flow because there is an open circuit on the input side. Okay, so remember that. Now all this is found. Next we should find the output impedance. They have asked us to find R out. How do I find R out? As usual, we had done this. On the output side, I have GM VGS. I have R naught, I have RD, and what should I do to RL? I have to remove RL. So before RL, I should find, remove RL, connect a voltage source VX, sending a current IX into the circuit, and whatever resistance you see by this voltage source, that is your output resistance. So this is the equivalent circuit, and on the input side, the signal source should be shorted. So VSIG is made zero. There is an RSIG here, which is again connected to open circuit. So the input side will have no meaning. I can say this VI or VGS will be zero. In this case, since this VSIG is zero, the voltage here is also zero. The drop across this is also zero. Though there is a resistor, since there is no current, there is no voltage drop across this RSIG. Okay. So what do I have? What do we normally do? We did it. So this, since VGS is zero, GM into VGS should be open. I'll remove this GM into VGS and leave it as open. So in effect, what is the resistance seen here by Vx? What is the amount of resistance seen by this voltage? It is the parallel combination of these two resistors. So you can directly, you should, without writing all this equivalent circuit, you should be able to simply write R out will be R naught parallel Rd in such a common source amplifier. Okay. So we had derived the same thing here. We had shown the output impedance R out is R naught parallel Rd. Okay. Same thing here also. We'll get the value as R naught parallel Rd. Can you tell me? I think this is 20K in parallel with 20K, right?
18.18 kilo ohms.
200K in parallel with 20K. Okay. 18.18 kilo ohms is your output impedance. Okay, we have found all the parameters. Let's go back to the problem. What else is asked? Rin, AVO, R naught or R out is the same. AV and GV. So sometimes they'll call this AV dash as AV. Remember, very often AV dash is denoted as AV. So we'll call AVO, AV and GV, the representation, open circuit voltage gain with load, overall voltage gain. Okay, finally, there is one more part of the question. To maintain linearity, if Vsig peak is 10% of VOV, what is the peak value of V naught? So he has given us the input signal generator voltage and he is asking us to find the output voltage. See, if Vsig, usually remember we discussed this also in module 1, the input voltage or the AC input voltage will be chosen to be approximately 10% of this overdrive voltage, twice the overdrive voltage. We had considered this condition. Okay, let's complete this. So given Vsig is 10% of 2 times VOV for linearity, to maintain linearity in operation of the device. So how much is 10%? 0.1 into how much was VOV given us? I think 20.25. Yeah, VOV is 0.25 volts. He has already mentioned this. Even if they don't mention, you should be remembering this condition. Okay? One second. So what would you get here? 2 into 0.25.
0.05 volts.
Okay, 0.05, or can I say 50 millivolts? So this is the signal generator voltage. He is asking you to find what is the output voltage, final. So Vsig peak. When I say peak, we are representing one peak voltage, this one. Okay, one-sided peak voltage, Vsig peak. If this is 50 millivolts, what is the peak value of output voltage? V naught peak. Which voltage gain should I consider? The input signal generator voltage is given. The final voltage which you measure, you're going to see. So what voltage gain should I take? The overall voltage gain GV. Remember, the output is overall voltage gain GV into the input voltage Vsig peak. This is all you have to do. You will find the overall output voltage by multiplying the voltage gain GV with the peak value of the input signal voltage. How much is GV? Minus 19.047 into 50 millivolts. Whatever you get here, that would be your peak value of output voltage. Tell me how much is this? 19.595, right? You'll get something around 95 milli, yeah? How much would you get?
0.95 volts.
Okay. So 0.95 volts. And it should be negative, indicating this negative sign indicates 180 degree phase shift between Vsig and V naught. That means if Vsig is like this, V naught would be reverse. V naught will be higher in magnitude but opposite in phase. That is the meaning of this negative sign. Okay. So Vsig peak value is 50 millivolts, whereas V naught peak value is 0.95 volts. So whenever I have plus 50 millivolts, I'll have minus 0.95 volts as V naught. Is that clear? I hope with this problem, you have a better understanding of common source amplifier. Please ask if you have any doubts in this problem. Okay, I just want you to tell me, if I have this complete amplifier, okay, one second. If I have an say RD, RL, V naught, capacitor, DC voltage source, R1, R2, and one more coupling capacitor, R-sig and V-sig. Can you draw the equivalent circuit? Can you tell me what would be the difference between GV and AVO? In this case, GV will be, overall voltage gain will be different from voltage gain with load and voltage gain without load, open circuit. Can we draw the AC equivalent circuit for this and the small signal equivalent circuit? Try to analyze this. Actually, I had already shown you how to draw in the last class, and today also in the beginning I revised that. Please do it. I try to write the AC equivalent circuit here. Please understand. Source, what will happen to the signal generator? It will be there as it is. DC voltage source will be replaced with a short circuit. So, what do I have on the output side? I will have RD, RL between drain and source. And the voltage V naught is measured here. So output side, this capacitor will be shorted. This capacitor replaced with short circuit. DC voltage source with short circuit. So this end is grounded. So on the input side, what will you see? From the gate, you have one resistor R2 between gate and ground. What about R1? R1 also, one end is connected to gate, the other end is grounded. So you will see the resistance R1 also exists between gate and ground. And what else is there? This capacitance is replaced with a short. So you just have the signal generator R-sig with voltage source V-sig. That's it. This represents the AC equivalent circuit of this amplifier. Okay. So you can just replace the MOSFET and get the small signal model and try to derive. Let's continue with this in the next class.